As debate over AstraZeneca rages here in Australia, it's the Chinese-made vaccine Sinovac that's got authorities in Indonesia reassessing their strategy. The government has relied on Sinovac to immunise more than 1 million health workers, but a growing number of Indonesian health workers are falling ill and dying from COVID, despite receiving 2 Sinovac shots. Indonesia correspondent Anne Barker reports.
Ganang Aditama's wife died from COVID-19 2 weeks after giving birth to their first child. The intensive care nurse worked at a hospital overwhelmed with the virus, though she'd already had 2 doses of China's Sinovac vaccine.
All health workers here are struggling with COVID. Maybe she died from being exposed too much.
The young nurse was one of millions of Indonesians vaccinated with Sinovac, but a growing number of health workers are dying even after full vaccination. Over the past 5 months, nearly 90 doctors have died, 20 of those had received both shots. It's raised concerns about Sinovac's efficacy over the longer term.
We're wondering if we need a third booster. Experts are investigating.
Though hundreds of fully vaccinated health workers who've fallen ill with the Delta variant have recovered.
Sinovac would have been enough, but this mutation is causing the efficacy to be decreased.
Indonesia is not the only country grappling with the Sinovac vaccine. Trials around the world had already shown mixed results and little about its impact on older people. Chile has relied on Sinovac to vaccinate almost 2/3 of its population, but like Indonesia, it's struggling with a surge in new cases and deaths.
Of all the vaccines currently available, we know less about Sinovac than any other vaccine.
Professor Toole says with a growing number of Australians opting for Pfizer, the unwanted AstraZeneca doses here could number in the tens of millions. Doses which could prove a life-saving backup for health workers in Indonesia.
We're producing 1 million doses a week in Melbourne of AstraZeneca, and the uptake is just going to fall.
Barely 5% of Indonesians so far are fully vaccinated. Anne Barker, ABC News.